How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. Today, I'm going to show you guys three of the best VPNs you can get with an ad blocker included in them. So before we begin, if you're interested in any of these VPNs, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below. Besides that, you'll also find reviews if you'd like to know the ins and outs of these VPNs in terms of privacy policy, speed, streaming, torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. So be sure to check those out if you're interested. Everything will be in the description below. Now, I do have an opinion about these ad blockers that come with these VPNs that come with ad blockers. Generally, you know, they do a good job, just not good enough to kind of justify, let's say, purchasing a VPN just because it has an ad blocker. So I'm not really recommending these because of their ad blocking ability. You know, if you're looking for an ad blocking, you know, a top ad blocker, you can just get uBlock Origin or just Adblock. It's called Adblock. So, you know, right here on my Google, you can see that on my extensions, I do have Adblock and uBlock Origin. And these two usually just, you know, I keep these on both at the same time and they block most of the stuff. Now, if you'd like, of course, you can, you know, here, let's start with private internet access. Okay. So let's go to the settings. And on privacy here, you've got PIA Mace, which says block domains used for ads, trackers, and malware. And it's the same thing with NordVPN. So if you go to general here, CyberSec, there it is, block ads and malicious websites. So it can be useful here and there. Granted, Adblock and uBlock Origin do just about the same job, really, and just as well, if I have to be honest. And where is it actually? Is it, it's in features. So yeah, clean web block, ads, trackers, and malware. Now, if I'm trying to block malware, I'm not exactly going to depend on this feature here, which could block malware and it could not. I'm not exactly sure. What I do is I rely on TotalAV. So TotalAV, you know, it's actively protecting you against malware, Trojans, scareware, adware, ransomware, and other security threats. So that's what I recommend if you're looking for a true malware and adware blocker. So yeah, again, if you're interested in TotalAV as well, you'll find a link in the description down below for special discounts and updated pricing links, as well as a full-on review if you'd like to learn more about TotalAV. That's my opinion on these ad blockers. But of course, I'm not exactly recommending these VPNs just because of their ad blocking ability. These are top tier VPNs that are really just incredible in general. And if you're looking, I'm just going to give you guys a small brief. Now, of course, if you're looking for more information, please check the description below for reviews. I don't want to make this video too long. Because the reviews just have everything you need to know about these VPNs. But generally speaking, if you're looking to, let's say, I don't know, you're watching a streaming service and you don't want to see any of the ads on the side, or like, I don't know what it is you're trying to do for a VPN specifically with an ad blocker. But if you're looking to unblock streaming services and geo-restricted content, definitely go with either NordVPN or Surfshark. Now, NordVPN will offer a few extra services or a few extra features, such as specialty services, specialty servers, and then you've got, if you switch to OpenVPN UDP, it'll give you a couple of extra specialty servers, which are dedicated IP and double VPN servers, besides the onion over VPN and peer-to-peer. So generally, though, I would definitely recommend sticking with Nord Lynx, which is a true WireGuard protocol. It's incredible. But you lose out on double VPN and dedicated IP. So unless you need those, you can switch to OpenVPN. Of course, you have an app kill switch, which will terminate selected apps rather than terminating the entire network when the VPN disconnects. And in terms of Netflix libraries, NordVPN is able to unblock up to 10 libraries, and that'll be 15 with Surfshark. And as with private internet access, less than 10 private internet access. The reason I recommended NordVPN and Surfshark for streaming is because if you're looking specifically for unblocking streaming services, these will be the VPNs. Now, if you're looking for a VPN that gives you, you know, you'll be able to unblock most popular streaming services, but in terms of consistency, you might not find it to be very consistent in terms of unblocking these services. So that's why I didn't really want to recommend it. Now, if you're just looking to unblock, let's say HBO Max, you know, Hulu, and a couple of popular libraries such as the UK and American Netflix library, then you can definitely do that with private internet access. But not as consistent as Nord and specifically Surfshark. They're perfect for unblocking geo-restrictions, but you do have a lot of options with private internet access. You know, you get everything. Of course, more importantly, you do get port forwarding, so you can turn on port forwarding from here, or you can just turn it on from the user interface, the main user interface. You do get to kind of really customize the encryption here. So if you want to go for faster speeds, you can decrease the encryption here. It'll be less secure, but AES 128 is still pretty secure. Whatever it is that you're trying to do, you do have Shadow Socks and Socks 5. You can select ports. Generally speaking, and you do have a WireGuard protocol. So super powerful VPN overall. You're going to have to pay, of course, for the dedicated IP, which is, you could of course get for free on NordVPN, unless you're trying to get, an IP for just for yourself, in which case you're just going to have to pay for it as well. So yeah, these VPNs overall are just great. And that, you know, in terms of ad blocking ability, I mean, yeah, I would just turn the ad blocking feature on, as well as combining it with an ad blocker that you can get on your Chrome extension and whatnot. And if you're looking to block malware, then just go with Total AV. It definitely will do the job. So that'll be it for this video. Thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a wonderful day.